Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bunny Says. I'm back again, and we're going to continue on from where we left off. I'm going to continue just building this second floor area here. Okay, let's do this. The auto jumping is going wild again. Let's do from here over. Oh, something interesting I got. I just got an email. Email. It is. And, okay, I can't tell where I'm going here. There. There was a Kickstarter for a game called The Good Life. I'm not promoting it or anything. I want to play it personally, but it's because it's by the same guy who did Deadly Premonition in D4. The guy Swery. The Good Life is a game he's trying to do for himself. You know, it's kickstarting it, and I guess they're about 40% of the way. I guess they still have another like 28 days to go. But the point was that he's going to be at PAX East, and to show it, to try to drum up some, you know, interest in it. But it's funny. It was called has this. If you get a chance, take a look at it. Just look up on. You have to look on YouTube and press the Good Life. Type his name, type Swery, the Good Life, Swery, S-W-E-R-Y, and that'll, you'll see, it'll come up for a thing called White Owls Inc., I think it is called. That's his company, that's the company that's making it, you know, and, he's actually a really fun guy. He's really interesting, and he sort of always has this sort of strange sort of take on stuff. It's sort of fun. I always think it's a sort of fun and strange take on stuff. And he has it, you know, and it'll have a little bit of a warped sense of sort of sense of humor, you know. And obviously, like, I'm a Twin Peaks fan, and it's very obvious he has a very high regard for Twin Peaks. Like, he's a, you know, it certainly Twin Peaks has influenced him a great deal, particularly Deadly Premonition, you know. And he seems to like that type of sort of violence, something going on, or something perverted underneath things that are happening, you know. In this case, he's doing he calls it a debt simulator, which is sort of funny. It's supposed to be, the game is supposed to be a woman who's not a reporter, she's a photographer from New York, and she's on an assignment, and she gets to go to there's this town in England, and it's supposed to be a really small, like a little village, small village, you know, and like sort of out in the sticks, you know, but it's purported to be they call it the happiest place on earth. So she gets an assignment to go there and check it out, and she goes there and she gets sort of trapped there. I don't know how she gets trapped there. Like, I think she like loses her all her money and stuff like that, so she's trying to get her money back. Maybe, I don't know, maybe she's fired or loses her job or something and is trying to do freelance, because the idea is that she has to sort of stop making money to get out of there. And so, the thing is though, you'll constantly have stuff that'll happen and things you have to do to, you know, you have to do, like, all this minutia, like, eating and drinking and, you know, taking a bath, buying beauty goods and stuff like that. And you know, like I guess apparently there's like, you know, if you're, you know, she has to, she works too much, she gets unhappy, and you know, and you know, so maybe you'll do something like go out drinking, you know, something like that. Then you have to be careful, she'll get addicted to drinking and stuff like that, and she'll do it. She'll have all these weird jobs to do, like shearing sheep and stuff like that, like this weird like little village stuff to do. But the but I think the main thing was that she has a like the village. I guess all the people in the village sort of have their own schedule and they go there about their own business and stuff like that. So you know, it's you could go around and like, yeah, like they'll have their own schedule, so they, you know, they'll go about their jobs and go about whatever tasks they're doing and stuff like that. I guess the whole town is modeled, or the whole village is modeled. So and then the thing is that so she'll be sitting there trying to make money, trying to get out. Okay, it comes back three. Okay, yeah, that's all. So, it's supposed to be a sort of quirky village, you know. And then the problem is that she comes across, I guess apparently she comes across a murder. Somebody's like violently murdered. And so, I guess she's stuck there. She's also stuck there in the village. She can't leave because she's a suspect. So, there we go, perfect. And she's trying to sort of solve the murder, you know. One, to, I guess, to leave, and two, I guess, just to, I don't know, because she's, you know, sort of snoopy and she wants to find out what's going on and stuff like that, you know. It's also for some bizarre reason you turn into a cat at nighttime, I guess, something like that. Like once a month you turn into a cat or something weird, or a dog. And you run, I don't know, the whole town I think turned into a cat. Something really bizarre. I was like, what the hell is this? But it's just the idea of you know, having a sort of, you know, a quaint rural English, it's a British village, and just all the sort of you know, having all the different characters and all the different sort of weird characters in the town and stuff like that, you know, I thought it was like just a sort of cool idea. I thought it'd be really cool. I'm looking for. I really hope it gets done because I'm looking forward to playing it. I particularly enjoyed these last couple games, the D4 and Deadly Premonition. Oh, Deadly Premonition certainly had its got it, its problems. It was just the resolution in it. I think it was mostly the resolution problems I had with it. Well, no, there was some other stuff too, but it was sort of the port, you know. But, oh, okay, hold on, I ran out of pickaxes. But, I still enjoyed it despite all that. Because I just, I don't know, I had a weird sense of style to it. No matter what, the games, his games always seem to at least have a style to them that, is uniquely his own, you know. And I don't know, I sort of appreciate that. This it's you don't see that too often, except for a lot of people who either have enough influence that they could change up a game on their own and have their own sort of style and their own sort of a sense of vision, I guess, of what they want. Or really independent people who are working on smaller projects where they could have a far greater influence on what's going on, you know, and sort of make it their, yeah, make it sort of unique in themselves. And I think he sort of likes to work on this type of thing, sort of medium level projects, you know, like they don't, it's not like it, they're not looking for a huge amount of money. I think it's like $500,000 or something. No, it was like $600,000, which, I mean, obviously that's a lot of money, but, you know, for a game, you know, that's a little, it's a little different, you know. It's not, you know, it's not a AAA game. It's not hundreds of millions of dollars or whatever. But, what was that? A weird noise. Okay. Did I hear something? Yeah? Okay. But, it has a weird sort of quirky sense to it, I think the game seems to have. Yeah, he's going to be at PAX East in Boston. Actually, it's nearby. I wanted to go, but, you know, there aren't any tickets. I didn't really have the money to go anyway, but it would have been interesting to see it. The game itself has a sort of cool style to it. I sort of like the style. And it has, they had originally done part of it, and they fixed it up. They fixed up more of it now. At first, they had tried to get it going on Fig, and they couldn't get it going. And Fig is not like Kickstarter type of thing. And yeah, but since then they have changed it and fixed it up. And, I mean, they made the entire game sort of more detailed. If you saw it before and you know what it looked like before, go back and take a look at it now. It looks it's a lot more detailed, and the character models look more detailed, and the town itself looks more detailed and stuff. It looks really nice. Okay, let me see. I want to, let's take a look downstairs here and see how this looks. Yeah, okay, that's perfect. I really like the idea of I really liked his idea of, Dr. Goyce's idea of the glass floors like that. Because I think that really looks really cool. Yeah, these glass floors look great. Alright, I really like the idea of it. Okay, yeah, that looks okay. That's looking good now. Put one of those things there. I wonder if I should put a door here. It might actually be sort of cool, but, well, maybe not. I don't have a door here, so what's the difference? But, yeah, so I was looking at the game and hoping it would come out soon. Hoping it would kickstart. I'm wondering if I should fill stone in here. Okay, I'll leave it that way for now anyway. Fill more. I'm gonna do this just to make just to offset the room and put a little boundary here. I'm gonna put some granite on the ground. Get a little sense of boundary, you know. There. That's all. Okay. And I think, weirdly enough, in PAX East at 5 o'clock, they're having a... It's this weekend, by the way. Actually, it should be starting today. Today's Friday. I should have started today. So it's Friday evening now, and he's having bizarrely a best practices in coffee making seminar at like 5 o'clock on Sunday or something like that. I guess at the very end of the thing. I have no idea what that would consist of. That sounds sort of funny to me. Oh, whoa, what's that little little zombie demon out there? Let him do whatever he wants. Okay. Now this looks this room looks much. Yeah, this looks very cool. Oh, over there. No, you know what? I'll put it there. Same thing here. Yeah. Yeah, that's actually very good. There. There. And I put one here. One here. Like that. Nope. There we go. And maybe we'll touch there. That's it. Yeah, that's bright. This whole place is bright enough. Looks good. Perfect. Wow, this looks great. I could put a bed up here, and I think I'll do that right now. I'll move the bed from downstairs up there. I want to change the color of my bed. Can I really? No, I don't. Okay. Oh, you know what? Let me get rid of all this cobblestone. Okay. Nope. Yep, well, let's do that, and gravel. Well, I'm gonna have to move everything eventually, won't I? So let's say I'll leave the bed there, so I'll leave the bed. Okay. Oh wait, do I have glass? Okay, I have the. Oh, you know what? Let me get rid of that one piece of stone. Let's toss it. Is it nighttime mode? Yes, it is. Okay. Let me get down here and what did I want to do here? Okay. Sandwich there, little steak, whatever it is. Is this polished? No, it's not. Okay. Let me put the flint together there. Let's see. I won't die, I know that, but I'm looking up what I might drag back with me here. Okay, yeah, let's do this first. Okay, and what do we have here? Okay, yeah, let's start doing this. Okay, am I filled up already? Okay. Yep, I am. All right, let's start the process of moving stuff around. That shouldn't be too hard. Now, let's see, where am I going to put my chest? You know what? Should I make the room this big? Maybe I should cover up to here. Yeah, you know, you know what? I actually might do that. want to, yeah, you know what? Because a part of me doesn't want a huge, huge space like that. Okay, so I'll put a wall from here down. And, yeah, that's plenty. That's plenty of space. I don't need more space than that. What I'll do is I'll just put up a... okay, let me throw this down here for a minute. Just to get rid of this stuff. Just this sort of junk here. And... yeah, let me... okay. Let's try to get rid of some of that stone too, by the way. Yeah, okay, yeah, let's do that. You know what? Yeah. And you know what? I'll just put the wall there. But I won't, I'll leave this space here. Okay, there we go. Let me get this last piece here. Yep, that'll do it. I'll from here over. Okay, yeah, right here. And I won't fill in this whole spot because maybe I'll have use for it later. Or maybe, you know what? Maybe I'll put the tree here. No, I'm gonna have the tree right there. Very big. I'll have the tree right here. Like I was saying. Actually, you know what? Let me just grab some of this granite here. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, okay. 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20. Okay, and I could fill it in with a stone or granite or gravel, whatever. Okay, there we go. That's okay. Grab some cobble. Oh, I have plenty of cobble. I have cobblestone right there. I can. And I can fill in. And I'll just put stone there. No, I want to put the. Back. Okay, there we go. And okay, I still have E left over. No, I have all the stone in my inventory already. Okay. Okay, yeah. That's okay, that's what I'm gonna do here. Like that. Okay, here we go. I'll put a torch here. That'll keep the monsters from spawning, hopefully. Okay. Oop. Okay, didn't mean to do that. Alright, there we go. Okay, now. Yeah, that doesn't look so bad. In fact, it looks very good. So they just had to move the torches, that's all. In there, and move this over a couple. There we go. Put a couple of torches here, and me one here. Okay, no, let's move it over one. There we go. Alright, that's okay, that's good. Let's move a torch there and a torch there. Just to even out the torches a little bit. Okay. Okay, there we go. Like that. Okay, yeah, the light looks even. That's nice, even sort of. Okay, that's good. Now, up here, I want to. I'm wondering if I should even walk. Like, I should. Maybe I make a stairway going down into this area. That'll be sort of fun. It'll be like a. You know what? I'm going to see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stairways down, so. To be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have to start about here. You know what? Let me do that. I'm gonna take a look at that. Let's see here. I made a stairway to be 1, 2. Oh no, I have to smack into that wall. Well, so what? Why not? I guess I could. I mean, if I started here, be 1, 2. Yep. That. Okay. Sure. Okay, let's do that. Should I? I don't know. I want to rate the aesthetic here going on. Yeah, okay. You know what? For right now, I will. I'll put stairs going down there. I got some stairs for my other. Oh, you know what? Okay, I'm gonna need stone. Let's get rid of some dirt for right now. Okay. We can move on here. I know I have stairs here. Yeah, 6 stairs. That should I? Oh, wait, I'm gonna grab some stuff. What am I doing? Okay. Okay. Anyway, yeah, there's a big pack. The PAX East is going on here in Boston. And I wish I could go. That would have been really fun, I think. I've never been to one before, so I don't know. I mean, it seems like it's the more fun version of like an E3. Like E3 seems to be more on the business side, you know. Whereas PAX seems to be more for fans and for fun and that type of thing. So I mean, that to me, that right there is enough for me to want to go. Excuse me. A little sip of water. Yeah, my throat was drying out a little bit. Yeah, it sounds like it might be a blast, you know? Let's see, what am I going to do here? Okay, alright, I guess, nope. It's not gonna be good here, let me. Nope, not upside down. What are you doing? Okay, well, you know what? I'll leave the stairway like that. Okay, let's, yep, I have this here. Let's fill this in. Like that. Okay, yeah, that, okay. My very own little crazy secret room, I guess. I have no idea what I'll do with it, but, I don't need a lot of light. I already use light. I don't know. I get okay. You know what? I'll just leave it there. Leave it there for now. Let me put the. Okay, could I go down there? No. I don't want to hit my head. So there. Oh, you know what? Oh, okay. I'll put the second one there. Yeah, there we go. Or maybe I should go. I want to stay where to start here. I don't want to start one back. And I think the idea is when I come up here, the room will sort of go that way. So I'll put my bed like here on these two couple squares. I put down here. I don't know. I wonder if I should have started the wall underneath this red line and not further back. And I'm thinking I might be right. I should have started. Let me look. Look here underneath this red line here. Yeah, I don't think so. Well, that wood looks weird, but no, I'm right. Yeah, that's yeah. Yeah, that's okay. I feel that's correct. Yeah, you got my pan, there's a big room up here, and I wish I could have a way to cover over, and, I mean, I don't know how to, oh, I could have had I could have a ladder going down, instead of a stairway. You know what, maybe I'll do that. In the very corner here, just the ladder going down, you know? I may have to close up the entire thing. Yeah. I just want this area to be unobtrusive, and yeah, you know what? I think I will do that. I think I'll put a ladder instead. That's a one square ladder, and that's perfect. Sticks. That's how I make ladder. How many squares will I need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe. Okay. Let's do that. Yeah, okay. Alright, there we go. Although, I guess I'm coming up here and I don't really see the stairs until you get up close, so it doesn't. Okay, you know what? Let me just take a look at what it'll look like with the. the ladder. Okay, let me just put the ladder here. I need to okay. There we go. And I need one more to put there, but otherwise I'm digging that a lot more. And you know what I will do? I will put up a little wall with a doorway there. Like, you know, I'll put a little wall here and make a little doorway there, and it'll be like a little alcove of, yeah. I'll go with a ladder. I'll put a wall up. Yeah. I'll put a just a doorway there and just, you know, open the door and go down the stairs. You know. Yep. That's it. And we'll block off to that way you won't see the stairway, you know. I mean, you won't see the ladder or anything. I just, you know. Yeah, well, okay. You have one piece of granite there, and you need a door. Okay, I'll get the door later. Just put the. There we go. Yeah, that's perfect to me. Except for that giant hole up there. There we go. Yeah, okay, that's, yep, that's okay. I'm digging that a lot. Yeah. Okay, this one's looking good, I think. Oh yeah. I said I could block off here the wall, same as the other downstairs, and have a doorway that opens up into the. You know what? I think I will do that. Okay, yep. Okay. I'll put one of these stones here again. There we go. If anyone is listening to this and they happen to be attending PAX East, please write it in the comments, and so you'll be stunningly jealous. Sort of fun to know, well, it'll be fun to know what you think of it, you know, or if you've ever been there before or what. Okay, let me put a couple torches here just to make sure there's light. 2, 3, 4. Okay, yep. Yeah. Stone up here. is. Okay. Torch here. And that should be plenty. There we go. And put up a torch there and a torch there. No, little. There we go. Okay, let's take a look here. You know what? I'm gonna grab the door since I'm gonna start moving some of my more stuff into here. Okay, I might as well start putting down some chests now. Where am I gonna put them? There? I'm wondering. I don't know if I want to put them on the red thing because I don't want to. I guess I should, but I don't want to mess up the red stripe. No, wait. Okay, so say there's a space here, then two more, and space, then two more. I'll have the same problem here because it'll be two here, then. Well, I'll leave it there. Okay. I will do this, though. I'll start transferring from here. Okay, let's immediately start doing this. Actually, do that and this. Nope, I mean, like that and. Okay, like that. This, all that stuff. Okay. Let's see behavior. I'm gonna do this. This. That. Name tags. Okay, mushrooms. Slime balls. Oh, no. Yeah, got it. Well, no. Yeah, okay, that's it. And oh, go, yeah, okay, yep, that's it. Yeah, I'll leave those there. Okay, so we have one on here. I'm gonna move these later into that other chest. But in the meantime, stick those here. Oh, okay, yeah, that there. Yep. Oh, no, okay. I gotta stick the stairs. Oh, no. I have these things to stick there. Okay. Oh, and more arrows. Okay, there we go. Yep, let me move this chest over. Look like that. You can't put the chests directly next to each other, that won't let you. So, what I'll do is I'll start doing this. Yeah, okay, there we go. Anyway, hope everyone has a nice weekend. It'll be interesting to see what comes out of PAX East. wonder if they'll show anything, like there'll be any kind of special showcase, you know, for games. Usually something. I'm trying to think what might be coming out that that might show off. You know, I'll leave that there. I'll leave all that stuff there for right now. Oh, by the way, I was looking outside, and this is the bizarrest thing. I was out maybe 3 or 4 hours ago. It was about 50 degrees Fahrenheit, right? It's about 10 degrees Celsius or so around there. And, let me do this first. And just a few minutes ago, it started snowing. So, somehow bizarrely, in between the last few hours, it dropped down about 15 to 20 degrees enough to start snowing. I mean, it was warm. It was, you know, it was like 50. It was like a spring, a chilly spring day. Wasn't too warm, but it wasn't really cold either. That's why I want the door. Okay. So. Yep. Okay. And somehow in the last like 3 or 4 hours, it suddenly dropped. It must have dropped 20 degrees. There's a big fat snow out there. I was like, what the hell? I was just outside and it was warm. Okay, I'm gonna do this. I'll put the rails down here. So this really is the stuff that'll be temporary. This will go there. Okay. This is the stuff I want. Put that over there for right now. Okay. Okay, so far so good. Ooh, okay, alright. The time's getting long. I'm going to shut it down for right now. I'm going to shut down this file, I mean. And say thank you for joining me. And I hope you have a nice weekend, like I was saying. And, if you do happen to go to PAX or anything like that, just, you know, tell me in the comments if you're going. I'm just wondering what it'll be like. That seems pretty interesting to me. I would like to know if you had a cool time or what, you know. My brother is going with his kids. He's a gamer too. He likes playing games. And there we go. And he's just going on Sunday. You can only get tickets just for Sunday, so. And apparently he's just gonna show up to check out some stuff and take off, you know. But, anyway, that'll be sort of fun. I'd like to see what's going on there. But in the meantime, I'm going to say goodbye for now. And thank you for joining me. And I hope you join me next time. I'll be moving all the rest of my stuff there and checking out, making up the rest of that thing. I'm going to do? I'm going to take a look at some furniture. Because I don't really know how to make furniture except for a chair. So, the inside of my buildings, rooms and stuff always seem rather empty because I can't sort of fill them up with a lot of stuff. That's partly why I closed off this wall too, because I didn't, I knew it was gonna look empty, you know, just a big giant room would look empty. So, where is that? Don't have it there? Okay. Put that there. Okay. So, anyway, this is Bunny Says, and I'll say goodbye for now. Thank you for joining me. And hopefully you join me again next time and see what else weird stuff I'm doing here, what else I do to this room. So, thank you for joining me, and I'll say goodbye for now. Thank you.